And this is where it all began for the Beatles. The sign reads, Liverpool's own Cavern Club. Doesn't look like much, does it? Well, 11 years ago, the Beatles played music to a young teen crowd which drank Coca-Colas. Today, the crowd is older, the drink stronger, the music louder.
What do you find the reaction is among the high school students in Sacramento? And show, especially the girls, they seem to react what you might call violently to the Beatles. What did you think of that?
I thought it was terrible. I just couldn't stand it. You couldn't hear them singing for the girls screaming and yelling and jumping up and pulling their hair. It was terrible.
How about the Beatle haircuts that seem to be the fad?
Oh, they're all right to a certain extent, but boy, I'd hate to see them get out of hand.
Gary Park at the San Francisco International Airport. The young ladies in the background are singing the Beatle love song, I suppose. As you may have guessed, about an hour and a half from now, the Beatles will be arriving here at the airport. They tell us there will be 50,000 people here by that time. About 30,000 here now, I would guess. Most of them apparently young girls between the ages of 12 and 16 years old. Incidentally, in case you haven't heard, the Beatles are four young male singers from Great Britain, and they'll be appearing in concert tomorrow night at the Cow Palace. Unabashed enthusiasm, that's what we have here.
A couple of requests to do a tune called Kansas City, so we'll have to do that.
Kansas City, gonna get my baby one time. Again. Well, she was just 17, you know what I mean. And the way she looked, way beyond compare. How could I dance with another? I fall in love with her.
pole.
Show him, go on, you show him.
Show him.
Anybody you see?
There you go.
I've had him on for 3 years. Don't keep saying I'm changing.
Ringo, can you look this way and hold your rings up?
Could you do it again, Ringo?
Ringo, could you?
One of this
one over here. Just one more for the East Coast.
East Coast.
One more.
Each time they've had, since I've been here in 3 years, a new release, we've had the store packed. We've had people standing outside just to get in, just to hear it.
I never did miss them. I didn't like their type of music, so it doesn't bother me one way or the other.
Well, I don't miss them, like all the sake of the youngsters, you know, they all like them.
What do you like about the Beatles?
Well, just Beatles.
Oh. Yeah, because I'm not a teenager, and I prefer gospel singing. We have a radio in town now. KBR, and I hear Tony Fontaine. He's my favorite.
I just love them. They're really cool. Especially Paul McCartney. I'm really going to miss him a lot. I'm sorry that they have to break up.
What were you saying now about
that? I said that the Beatles revolutionized American rock and roll. It used to be that we had just fast dancing, that it really wasn't any good at all. And now the Beatles have got good clean-cut songs, and they brought more clean-cut groups into it. And so that now American rock and roll has completely changed, and now it's really fab, and the Beatles are great.
And here they come. Here come the Beatles. George Harrison, Paul McCartney, John Lennon, and Ringo Starr. All four of them rather ordinary young men, except for the hair, the reputation, and the newsman.
You said, well, you haven't. John hasn't
also
sold
fall to the ballroom.
No, I just forgot mine. You know, they got me up to
the place. Please be great. Get great.
Which John. One is married?
All right, Silla.
What? We all got married.